And so another one is we actually go and find a local troop, which would be, we call it resident troop, which is the one that's kind of closest to the sanctuary. The sanctuary has like 16 hectares of trails and transects. So we basically, if you do an identification or behavioral follows, you go around looking for these wild troops on those trails. And so when you find a troop, for behavioral follows, what you do is you do a focal sample on one individual for half an hour. One intern does that. And then another intern does a scan sample. So what that's like is, say if we were to walk up to this right now and look up and see this troop and headed on top of you, I would, if I was doing the focal sample, look at one individual and write their behavior down on that ethogram. Every second what they do for a half an hour. And then the scan samples, every 10 minutes, they scan the area and see what behavior all the monkeys are doing, their distance from each other, and stuff like that. And you also mark the height and other important information. Another one we did is transects. It didn't have as bad as Dave. Ours were actually little trails, kind of like what you see here. A lot of these photos aren't mine as well, so kind of But yeah, this is just kind of a cool picture illustrating kind of what they were like. You walk through the jungle, and what I liked about this moss is my favorite. Because I'm part of the birding club here at Paul Smith's, and I really do enjoy birds. And I was really excited when I got there because I knew there were over 900 species in Panama, and I wanted to see at least a couple of those. And so you'd walk through these transects, and you, mammals, howler monkeys, whatever you saw, you'd stop, take a GPS point in the direction you saw it. If it's a bird, you can, if you knew the species, you'd write it down, or at least type. If you heard a howler monkey, which I'm going to imitate right now, it's like a deep, they do this like territorial disputes, and so if you heard one of those, you try to estimate how far they are. So they sound like a, it's like a really deep howl. And so I could do that and actually talk to them if I got good enough. But or I would just distract other interns while they're on behavioral follows, and they'd be like, there's one on the ground, that's not normal. But just some of the cool stuff I saw, you know, like some of the cool birds. These obviously aren't photos I took. But probably the two superstars were the crested oar pendula and the blue mop mop. I saw both of these, like, the crested oar pendula I saw every day, every hour. They do this interesting sound like a... They do this, like, weird thing you can hear like a sci-fi movie. So I did that too, and I could talk to them a little bit. So as the other interns thought it was pretty strange. The blue crown mama is just a majestic bird. I saw that like in pairs. You just turn around and see one, you're like, whoa, that's pretty crazy. Some other cool birds I saw there. Lance-tailed mannequin on the side. That would do, what would that one sound like? I don't know, I can't find that one. Just some other really cool birds. Cuckoo on the left, flycatcher up top, falcon. Some warblers I saw there. We got the flame-throated, and we got tangent of the red stripes on the bottom. And then some hummingbirds I saw. These are some of the species I saw while I was there. So if you weren't doing research projects or doing all your chores, or you actually got some time to just relax, get out of the sun. It was so hot there, I can't really explain that. No air conditioning, had to sit sleep on the top in a bunk bed. You were just basically sweating your whole time. We were there, so if you actually got the shade, it was nice. And so we hung out in hammocks. This is a view from the platform at the sanctuary. I'd probably sit here whenever I could and just like, you know, and lose yourself in the view. Yeah, that's actually the ocean out there that goes out to the ocean. And on a half day, we had once a week, we'd go out to town and just kind of explore the local town, which was always an adventure. And whatever time I was, I'd actually get to go hang out with Cloud, which I had a good time doing. And I'll play a little video of just what the animals are like when they kind of were just playing around, just hanging out at the sanctuary. Yeah. Cloud's, he plays rough, so if it looks like I'm playing rough with him, he plays rough.
And everything is going to the beat. And everything is going to the beat. And everything is going to the beat.
That's Nina and Ninja. Peace, the other one, he was really awkward. Man. He would just like run away from me sometimes. He was in, by himself in the cage, so whenever I climb. They have a pretty good life. They just get to eat food and play around all day long. That's Mr. T, like I said. Just some other little critters I saw. Obviously, beautiful butterflies. The owl butterflies about like this big. But you can see them in the jungle. That's a woolly possum on the left. And if you've ever taken any classes with Eric Schmandl, you'll know he really likes cane toads. So when I heard that was a cane toad, I was really excited. So I think I watched like 3 documentaries in that class about cane toads. So that's one of them. And I don't know if they're native or not, but probably not. Little creepy crawlies, scorpion, spiders in the bathroom, really creepy. This spider I pulled off an intern's bed. I was the only one that would like mess with the spiders, so they just screamed my name. If one was around. The tarantula on the right, I tried to pick it up, didn't work out. Oh yeah, when I was there, I got to work with Students Without Borders, which is a great opportunity to do some education. They were from British Columbia, students from high school students from there. Basically what I had to do is, I actually got to give a lecture, and then I got to bring them to the native village, and work with some natives and show them the native life, which I haven't even done yet. So I was pretty excited. And they were a great group of kids. And so we basically hiked up to the main Cherokee, it's like this Novi village, spent the night there, and then we hiked up to this mountain, as you can see a little. And there was a village on top of that mountain. And so when we went there, obviously a huge hike, it was probably 6 hours altogether. So it was a full day event. The kids were great. Like I was expecting some kid to just break down halfway, because it was just 85 degrees humidity, beating sun, you're just sweating. You know, I'm just sitting there like, wow, this is tough. And somebody, I'm just surprised when these kids didn't turn around, like, I'm done, turn around. Like, we can't turn around. You know, so it was great. They powered through it and we made it to the village. This is an example, like this kid on my shoulders here, you know, he probably does this walk maybe once a week, see his family or so. But it just give you an example of like what they how the native people live, and you kind of learn to see their perspective, you know. They do this every day just to maybe get a bag of rice, or just to, like Dave said, he was probably, you know, 2 hours from the local supermarket or wherever. So that kid, that's a seating photo. He was leading the way most of the time. But these are just some of the beautiful views I got to see. And we went up to the village. The natives love showing us their culture. They're making sombreros in this picture. On the top right, you can see them actually done. I think it takes like a couple weeks to make them. It's a lot of work. But again, they just were showing the kids, and it was just a great experience for the kids. This is a Novi woman making actually a little hand basket. You can see on the table, they're really hardy, and so is the sombrero. They're just like really tough and really well made. A lot of care into that. And they just love showing us their culture, hanging out, ate some food there. So that is actually, it's pretty cool. They ran our lunch on like banana leaf. We put it in our backpack and take it up and eat it. That's basically just rice, beans, and like some jungle chicken, which the chickens are really great. That's just, and when we were up there, they cooked us a meal very similar. You can see how they use the native bowl. That's just a fruit, a hard fruit that's cut out. They make bowls out of it. And that my spoon is like a leaf or something. It's some kind of renewable resource. That's just us hanging out, eating a little food, a little grub from the long hike. Freshly grown coffee there was cool. I'm not a coffee drinker, but I am on the top of the mountain in Panama. this is me just chatting with some native villagers. They're really nice most of the time. They didn't laugh at my jokes, but they were really nice, and they just were very talkative and wanted to know where I was from. They were like, New York, New York, and they were really excited. This is a gentleman actually had some herbal medicine that I tried out. It's good for your circulation, supposedly. It tastes a little funky, but it looked like goat's blood. I thought it was some kind of, that was kind of scary when I first, but I took a shot of it. It was nice. This is a native dance that they showed us, which is really special. They do this with like births and other special events in their society. So you basically circle up and do this circle. We actually did it in class one day with Kurt after we did some ice corn. It was very, it worked. We got the core. This was interesting. That's an stuffed ocelot on my back, which is kind of, this is a dance they did. So the second time, I did this trip twice. Took one group, came back. They stayed at Alawat Sanctuary, learned a lot of things. And I was always up at the village with a group. And so when I was up here, the second time, they knew we were coming back up, so they had like a new chair, and they were all like set up for the second time. They also showed us this interesting dance, which it came out with this backpack. I'm like, wow, that's an ocelot, and it's got a bell on its bottom. And so basically, we walk around with it with a stick, and they ring the bell and like throw the stick at somebody, just a pair of people, and then you would do the same thing. So they do it back and forth, they run around and throw the stick, and you pretend to fall. And so after they were done, and this is before that, they were calling out for some guy. Maybe, I don't know who it was. We're calling out in the woods for this guy. And at the end, they gave it to me. I'm like, okay, I can run around. I'm excited. But then, of course, when I get the backpack, the guy comes out of the woods. He's got the chief hat on. He's got this like hat on with the ornaments. So I'm really scared. I'm taking the backpack off. Like, hey, you can take it back. I don't want it. And he's like, no. He comes over and puts his hat on me. It just shows the kind of respect they have. Just what they want to show for our culture. So there I am, running around on the middle of Panama with this hat on, doing a native dance. I might have known a wife, I think. I'm not really sure when I go back. But yeah, I'm not really sure what the consequences of this dance was. I think it was something like that, like marital or something. But this is me kind of throwing the stick at him, and he threw it back at me. And I was playing along, and they loved it. They were laughing and having a good time. And they showed us places like this that, I don't know if I mentioned it, but you know, we were the first group to ever go up here, of a large group of white people, even outsiders for that matter. So this was just really epic to see, really the first people to see this view, which is just magical. And we went back down, which is a long hike. And this is the family I stayed with for the four nights I was in the village. The woman on the right made this design, the shirt I have on now. Just really, really genuine people. Really want to take care of you, really want to just, you know, they just invite you in. And with this, just really, you know, when I look back at the people I've met and what in my experience there, it was the monkeys and the primates were incredible. And the science and all that's great, but it's, you know, it's really about the people. You know, you get involved in these, you know, if you can even ask Dave, when you're in the middle of the jungle with a field crew, you got to work together, you got to be doing each other's family. So you have to know people really quickly, work well together. Just like this trip with the, you know, British Columbia group of the students. They were all great and just became really good friends. That's Seth in the background, the director of the sanctuary. You know, and especially when you're away from home, like Dave was there for 3 months, I was there for a month. You know, I missed Christmas and New Year's. So, you know, that's when you become the most homesick. And so when I was there, this is like us having a good like Christmas dinner. So you just had a great time. Do what you can do in the jungle, you know. Yeah, that's it, really. The people made the trip. I'll have friends for, you know, the rest of my life, hopefully, and make connections down there. So I advise everyone to do it. You know, go travel. You learn so much when you get lost in the middle of the jungle or wherever you are. Yeah, that's basically it.